Everybody, I just realized that we haven't done premium content in a long time. I don't know why, you know, part of WCC, right? You can see it here. And being part of WCC means that premium should be the only thing you're thinking about, right? Like premium format, premium chocolate, premium economy, you know? That's the stuff that we should be thinking about. So we got to rectify that today. And it's a perfect day for rectification because not only is clan selection out, but apparently a lot of people are also interested in premium after they realize that there will be a hard reboot, right? So yeah, well, clan selection's out. Chaos Breaker is out. That's the other big thing too. And even though Chaos Breaker Dragon might not be like a top tier deck or anything like that, it's chaos, dude. It's chaos. Everyone cares about chaos, all right? Like, it could be the worst deck in the world and people would still be caring about chaos. It's just the fact. It's just the fact, right? So, I built premium chaos deck simply because I needed to test it for like the stream. I also built a standard chaos deck. Both decks really aren't that super strong in my opinion. I think like maybe standard chaos might be better than premium chaos. Just because there's a lot of more noobs in standard, and you can just go, hey, did you know about lock? Let me teach you about lock. And they're like, oh yeah, I know about lock. We'll play it against Messiahs. And you're like, yeah, that's right, bruh. You know about lock. But you know, in premium, everyone's like, knows about lock. They're like, oh yeah, you're playing Chaos Breaker. Get wrecked, son. I know what you're about. The only decks or people that you'll probably beat are like the people who have no idea what chaos does, or just goes to the forums and complains about chaos every day, right? So yeah, basically premium is just split between two kinds of decks at the moment. That is the top decks, right? The strong combo loop Genesis Kagura decks right now, and then everything else. And the funny thing is that chaos doesn't fit in anywhere because it's definitely not beating all the top decks. All the top decks have good people piloting them usually. That's why like those decks is like so strong that they'll also know how to beat your chaos. I've seen this 6 years ago, buddy. All right, was it 6 years ago? Maybe 4 years ago, something like that. But then if you go down to like the not top tier decks, you're going to be facing a lot of people who are either new to premium or they just don't really have the tools to deal with your deck, or they do have the tools, but the deck sucks anyway. So they're just gonna get wrecked by chaos. So yeah, chaos really doesn't fit anywhere because either you're not having fun facing all the strong players or the strong decks, or your opponent's not having fun because they can't deal with your deck. So that's basically chaos in a nutshell. If you want to build chaos, you better get ready to sacrifice all your friendships because sooner or later, no one will be playing with you. But let's get to the deck now because I've been talking about chaos for too long. This is nostalgia content pretty much. All right, so this is the deck. Quick zoom. Now, I will teach you guys the most important combo in premium for basically every single Star Vader deck out there. In my opinion, of course, other people have their own opinions. But my idea is that Freeze Ray is probably the most important card in premium because against good people, you force a lock. Against decks that try to suck their field away or like throw it to Jupiter or whatever, it will still guarantee a lock. You gotta, but stop, bruh. Stop traveling to wherever. You gotta stay locked. And this basically guarantees you a card on the field for you to lock next turn. And if it's a front row card, even better. Even better, right? So this is one of the most important cards. And also he's a Cyber Dragon, which is actually kind of important because there is another card that looks for Cyber Dragons. And that is Gravity Collapse Dragon. Now this card is interesting, is that when it hits, you can look at the top five cards of your deck and ride a Cyber Dragon from them. A grade 3 Cyber Dragon, in fact. And both are grade 3s. Did you know Chaos Breaker Dragon is a Cyber Dragon, right? Lore. But they're both Cyber Dragons, so this means that if you go second, or if you go first, and you hit, you can superior ride up, right? And you might be going, this card has to hit, so it already sucks in premium. But I'm gonna tell you, if this card hits or doesn't hit, doesn't matter, bro. It doesn't matter. If it doesn't hit, if your opponent guards it, then he has no damage. So that's great. Because usually with no damage, they can't go as insane, right? Maybe Blade Master can go insane, but other decks usually can't go insane. Like some of the combo, can Nua Dio kill you with zero damage? No. It's kind of hard for him to kill him at one damage. Zero damage? Go buy a zero damage gaming shirt. So if he guards this, good times. If he lets it hit, and you look at top five and you get a freeze ray, then you're pretty safe, right? What is Valkyrian gonna do? You're just gonna lock it, right? If someone goes infinite and tries to multi-attack, just lock it. Blade Master gets a token, lock the token, right? Dunzo, he's done. Nua Dio, he's gonna combo you. Just lock his front row, right? Easy. If you ride a Chaosbreaker Dragon, that's kind of like, not that good. But at least you can access some G-Guards. Your G-Guards aren't amazing as well, so yeah. But at least you have slightly more options. You're on a 13k base. The worst case scenario is if you hit and you don't hit anything, you look at top five and don't hit anything, then you just cry, you accept the fact that you're playing a sub top tier deck, and yeah, that's it. That's life. If you want to hang with the big boys, you got to take some risks. And if the risks don't pan out, then go play Genesis. But this is why these two are in the deck, Gravity Collapse Dragon and Freeze Ray is in the deck. Just so, Freeze Ray, 100%, this is how you play Link Joker against good people. They have to really play hard to play around your Freeze Ray. It's not easy to play around Freeze Ray. So yeah, that's basically the two cards there. Let's look at some other cards here. So we have one Colony Maker. This Colony Maker lets us grab basically any grade one we want, and we're running Zinc, because Zinc is amazing, right? Who thought that if you print a card that says Soul Charge in and Counter Charge 2 and Soul Charge 2, it'd be bad. It definitely is not. It's really good. We have soul issues in this deck. I'm just gonna throw it out there. This card solves your soul issues, and you really, really want it. You really want it. So Colony Maker is basically our fifth Zinc. You care about the soul more than you do about the Counter Blast, by the way. You also run the new guy, Craving Claw. Why do you run in? Dude, you have to hit his things like an on hit and stuff like that. Well, I like advantage. I also like putting things into soul. So yeah, you can shuffle things around and grab markers during a turn. So that's okay. Just put on more pressure. But basically he's 10k body. He's got a nice, he's got a half decent soul effect, but yeah, he generates advantage. If your opponent is fully locked, then who cares about damage deny? Just bash his face, try and get some advantage, and it's all good. I was thinking of running like grade one nulls as well, just so like this can search the null and things like that, but it just came down to space. The last thing we're running is Barrowal. I can't say the name. It's like the Great Nature Stride, Balarl, but just with a centipede, right? This guy is basically the Soul Blast 1, Omega Lock kind of thing. Your position's good, bam. Your opponent can't unflip the next turn during their end phase. It also prevents counter charges. So if your opponent paid like 20 bucks for Grenache, it stops that. It stops that, you know? So, but it's just basically there for the Omega Lock. If you set up a nice position and just want to conserve some hand, pop this guy, bam, all good. The other cards we're running is we've got Globajula and Zirconium. These are basically cards that kind of fill up the board, right? If your opponent's board is like not full, then this will basically fill it up. Zirconium just very neat in that it also gives your Vanguard another like a plus crit effect, which makes your makes it two crit basically. So there's at least some pressure coming from the Vanguard rather than usually just three attack no pressure kind of builds. So very important, I think these two cards just fill up the board so you can just get more basically full board. It means less options your opponent can do and usually more things you can freely pop with Chaosbreaker Dragon. Chaosbreaker Dragon is just really like it's okay, you know, it's okay. Gets decent amount of advantage. The gift situation is a bit awkward, but at least you can kind of cuck out things like GB8 spikes. Boy, you built up some force markers. See you later, man. And you don't have to run a stride for that. So this is, yeah, Chaosbreaker. I mean, what else are you running, dude? It's a Chaosbreaker deck, right? The trigger lineup is 8-4-4. I did run 6 draws before. Usually I like 6 draws, but I got to a deck out situation quite often. But obviously this deck is a way more stally build compared to other decks. And but yeah, to help mitigate the soul issues, we do run the just 4 of the soul in trigger. So if you need that soul, pop that in. So now we move on to the G zone. So this G zone is kind of weird. The main focus of this deck is Alt Wilder, right? Who cares about Glendios, dude? Who cares about Stark? Stark, chuck him in the bin, right? We're going old school. We're going to GB8, all right? We're going to Alt Wielder style. Run two Alt Wielders. Why? Because if you make your opponent lock five from hand, you're winning. If you lock your, if you make your opponent lock five twice, then you're by winning, right? You're winning twice. So this is the ultimate win condition. It's very slow, right? But I personally like slow decks. Link Jogi can force games to be slow. So there we have it. And then the rest of this G zone is just glue balls. Glue balls, right? Original glue ball here gives power at GB3 to Starvaders and can basically mass lock the whole field. But this is basically not your, this is not your go-to first strike kind of thing. We've got Chaos Universe, right? Still around, still hanging out. We all got the new Glue Ball Avalanche. This guy's just a no-nonsense Soul Blast 1, Lock 2, pretty much. But it does have nonsense written on it, right? This is the first continuous... Why is he there? Now, I was actually thinking, right? Hey, you know what's cool? If we run two of them and then you bind your opponent's whole field and then your alt wield is just like freely plus 5, well, I mean minus 5 your opponent, or you run things like, I don't know, like the leaders. Yeah, nah, it was just a pipe dream. This is already pretty pipe dream, right? Alt wield is already the pipey dreamy kind of thing. But, you know, going that way, I don't want to go that far yet, right? The G-Guardians are just basically all jank. Honestly, Link Joker G-Guardians aren't very good. Just aren't very good. Destiny Dealer is your best bet now because you can unlock stuff and then use Chaos Breaker's effect and just get the nice sweet plus and that gift removal kind of thing. But he's also your biggest G-Guardian. The rest of it is like, what, Lacus Karina is just, he's there in a pinch. If you somewhat need to lock your opponent's back row, if you need to unflip quickly to get to GB8, then sure, she's there. This Cosmo Wreath, Lacus Karina Light, I guess, just in case. And then the last one we've got like is like Deshagen. This guy is just to Soul Blast one draw. You could probably just replace it with the Rack. I probably will replace this with Rack Tomb, man. It's like, I'd rather discard one and draw one than Soul Blast one and draw. I mean, Soul Blast one draw is like technically a plus one, but the soul is so important. I forgot to mention about Deluge. Deluge is just kind of your alternate win condition because your glue ball is going to hit big. Deluge can kind of drop cards from your opponent's hand. And if they're like an aggressive deck and they're forced to drop more cards from the hand, then it's basically just if they got no cards in the hand, you win, right? It's like mini alt wielder. So I run two of this, though. I don't know how many people usually run, but I run two of this. And I mean, like, what? No one runs alt wielder anyway. So, dude, I'm an alt wielder man. You can see there's no close. I did play with Chaos Breaker close before, like two copies of it. Just wasn't really any space. And he didn't really do much. Right? He didn't do much. The Soul Blast cost was pretty annoying as well. So that's why I cut him and just added like one Colony Maker and one Battle of the World. So that's it. You can just take it to casuals and have fun and make sure your opponent doesn't have any fun at all. Just buy him ice cream or something, right? Buy him ice cream or something so they don't get too pissed off when they can't play. But if they all have meta decks, then enjoy being the punching bag. Yeah, enjoy being the punching bag. How do you play this deck? Just play like any Link Joker deck, dude. Triangle lock him, get rid of his circles, all good. All right, so that's it. That's all the premium content today. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.